It's always better to record a voiceover for your video without background noise, but sometimes it's just unavoidable. I don't mean background noise like recording under the flight path of a busy airport or on a construction site. I mean those constant background sounds like a fan, air conditioning unit, or even the hum of a computer. In this video, I'll show you how to remove the background noise by using Audacity, one of the best audio tools around. Even better, it's free and available for Windows, Mac OS X, and Linux. Stick around to the end of the video for access to free video training and the link to the official Audacity download site. First, a quick overview of the interface, and then I'll demonstrate the noise reduction effect. Over here, you've got the usual toolbar. You'll go into that to do one or two things like opening files, saving audio files, using some effects, and maybe going into the preferences. Over here, you've got your monitoring of your input. Next to that, you've got the monitoring meters for your playback, and to the right, you can control the level of your input from your microphone, and you can also control your playback volume using this control over here. Below the playback meter and input levels, you've got your input and output selections. At the moment, I'm using a Focusrite Scarlett 8i6 USB sound interface. So I've got my line in selected to the Scarlett, and for the output, again, I've got it selected to the Scarlett. But if you're using a USB mic, you would select that for your input, obviously. We're going to be recording a voiceover, so that's going to be mono. So you select a mono track. If you were recording a stereo track, obviously you'd select stereo, but we're recording a mono track in a moment. The only thing for us left to do is to set our gain on the microphone. So click just there. You'll notice that we go into pause mode, and you can see the level on the meter. Ideally, you want to peak somewhere between about minus 12 to minus 6, probably, because then that gives you a little bit of headroom for those little loud movements, and hopefully you won't end up overloading the input. So when you're ready to start recording, just release the pause. And you can see immediately the waveform is being created on the screen on that track. Once you've recorded your voiceover, you might actually want to record a little bit of silence, or at least you be quiet and record a little bit of ambient noise. Normally, I would record voiceovers in my voice booth, which I have in my office, so that acoustically isolates me from any noises. However, today I'm actually wanting to demonstrate how you would deal with some background noises. If it's a constant sound, then you can actually remove it in Audacity, or do a pretty good job of removing it in Audacity. In this case, the sound is the fan or fans on my computer, and I will be quiet for a few seconds so that I can record just the sound, so that I can then have a reference to remove from the rest of the voice. So there you are. You have now got some background noise recorded into your file, so I would stop the recording. There's the silence that I recorded. You can actually see it's not absolutely silent, because there is a little bit of noise there. If I open up a little bit, you can see that it's not entirely clean audio. So if I click and drag, so I select a few seconds, I'll now go up to the effects, noise reduction, and click on get noise profile. Now, the profile, or the computer has sampled that part of the track, so I can now use that to remove that noise from the rest of the recording. So select all of the recording and go back to effect and noise reduction again, and this time just click OK. And you can see that a lot of that noise has actually gone. Let's just play that, so you should just hear silence. I'll let you hear what that noise was like. I'll just do an undo, and yeah, you can hear the sound of the fans there, but let's redo the noise reduction, and it's pretty much gone. To get our file out of Audacity, we go to File, Export Audio, and go to wherever you want to save it. I will call it Audacity Lesson, and then hit Save. If you want to put in meta tags, then do so, but I would normally just hit OK. And that's it, now saved.
So that's Audacity, a superb free tool for anyone who records voiceovers for their videos. If you haven't already got the program, I'd highly recommend it. The official download site is audacityteam.org. If you want to learn more about making videos to promote yourself or your business, I have 4 free lessons available from my course, Make Great Videos on a Budget. Click the link or the one in the description and look for the free training marked preview. Thanks for watching, and please hit the thumbs up and subscribe.